And great to have you back here on The Breakfast this morning. It's time for Today in History. 25th of February, I'm going back to 1965. It is the day that Muhammad Ali, previously known as Cassius Clay, defeated Sonny Liston. It was at that time one of the biggest fights on TV and all over the world. On this day, he shocked basically the odd makers by dethroning, at that time, the world heavyweight boxing champion Sonny Liston in a seventh round technical knockout. Liston at that time was a favorite, and of course, it was an 8-1 favorite at that time because he had initially or earlier before that fight demolished the former champion Floyd Patterson. Cassius Clay predicted victory, as always, but and that's one of the reasons why he was really, really popular, because of his mouth and his tongue and how much he was, how vocal he was at that time. He predicted victory, and of course, that's where the famous quote, "float like a butterfly, sting like a bee," came up. He said he was going to knock Liston out in the eighth round. About 8,300 spectators gathered at the Convention Hall Center in Miami Beach to see if the new kid on the block, Cassius Clay, will actually win that game. But the thing that happened in that fight was, in the first round, Sonny Liston suffered an injury. He hurt his shoulder, but continued, of course, to struggled through the fight until the seventh round, when he eventually had to discontinue the fight. And that was when Cassius Clay was eventually named winner of the fight. Clay announced he was joining the Nation of Islam not long after that and defended the organization's concept of racial segregation while speaking on the importance of Muslim religion in his life. Later also that year, he rejected the name that was given to him, Cassius Clay, and adopted the new name, Muhammad Ali. Also further down, after that fight, was where he was sentenced to 5 years in jail, mostly because he, refused to go to war, claiming that he was a Muslim cleric or Muslim, leader at that time. And so he chose to not go to war. He was sentenced to 5 years in prison and didn't serve, but, he still got that sentence. In 1974, he came back to fighting and, of course, won his match against George Foreman in Zaire. And of course, Joe Frazier, not long after that. He was stripped, basically. I think at the time that he was sent to prison, he was stripped of his titles and then regained them in those in the George Foreman and George Frazier fights.
Indeed. I'm so inspired by Muhammad Ali, formerly Cassius Clay. Remember how he would beat up people who refused to call him Muhammad Ali? He says, "Cassius Clay is a white man's name. I am not a white man. Yes. I have changed my name to Muhammad Ali. You don't call me Muhammad Ali." And he punched them, knocked them out. That particular fight on February 25th, 1965 was very, symbolic because, like you mentioned, what's his name now? The guy he fought against.
Sonny Liston.
Sonny Liston was very popular. Sonny Liston was a favorite. Basically, no one expected Muhammad Ali to win, even though he had won about 100 matches, for his category as an amateur at that time. But it was so impressive. I watched just how many times Muhammad Ali dodged the ball. Right. Like, he made good on his word to float like a butterfly and sting like a bee. I mean, Rocky Marciano, commenting on that fight, said he had never seen a boxer dodge so many punches like Muhammad Ali did. So remarkable. Tact checked, style checked. Muhammad Ali was just amazing, the greatest of all time. He spoke it into existence and, it became his title.
So two things. First of all is, if you watch the replays of that fight, it's one thing that would always stand out is, like you mentioned, the amount of punches that he was able to dodge.
Yes.
And still win that fight. A lot of people, of course, had given, I said earlier, it was an 8-1 count, basically, in favor of Sonny Liston. The fight was, very likely going to be Sonny Liston's, but Muhammad Ali, second thing I was going to say now, mm-hmm. is one of those people who loads of people that followed him learned the power of positive thinking, power of, your speech and the things that you say about yourself from him. Because whenever he said, this was what was going to happen, very likely happened. He claimed it was going to end in the eighth round. It ended in the seventh, but he was someone who carried himself like a champion,
yes.
carried himself like a winner, didn't in any way, let himself be intimidated,
indeed.
Both, on and outside the ring. So he is, till tomorrow, until his death, you know, one of the
greatest of all times.
Greatest, you know.
I mean, when you look at Muhammad Ali, zero fear, zero weakness, 100% confidence,
yes.
And listen to his speech, just, you know, moves you. He moves you with his words, really. And let's move on now to the second big event for today in history, 25th of February, 2004. What happened today was the debut, the movie screening of The Passion of Christ. It was released in 2004. It was a drama and epic. It was a controversial film about the last 44 hours of the life of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. It opened in theaters across the United States. Something very interesting I'm going to mention about this film is, so many movies have been made in the past about, you know, the life of Christ and all of that. But this one was very remarkable because of the quality of the acting, the quality of the cast. It wasn't just another movie about Jesus Christ. It was just so remarkable, you know. And I remember, you know, reading comments from people who were based in the US at the time this movie opened in theaters, saying that when they went to watch the movie, they didn't see anybody on the queues and they thought nobody had showed up to watch the movie. And someone came to them to say, oh, are you here to watch Passion of Christ? And they let them inside. So what that meant was they were trying to give an impression that nobody wanted to watch the movie. The movie wasn't selling out. You know, media really blacklisted the movie. There was just so much controversy about the movie. Critics said it was one of the most violent movies they've ever seen. And that's because in the movie, Mel Gibson, the director, tried to give a very vivid account, a very vivid portrayal of the life of Christ and how he was suffered and tortured on the cross. I mean, this movie, the actor, his name is Jim, he mentioned that carrying the weight of the cross basically broke his shoulder. He had that dislocation. And so many other interesting things happened on that movie set. There was a lightning strike 3 times on the movie set. You know, one of the cast and crew said they saw flames coming out from the side of his ear, from his hair. And it was just so remarkable. You know, eventually it seemed like this actor began to get blacklisted because, you know, of his passion for Christ. He was so focused on God. He would not act movies, you know, with nude scenes. He would not act movies where he had to, you know, be romantically involved in you know, in cast in some kind of way. And even though, you know, despite all of that, he went on to have a name for himself in the movie industry. The movie won the People's Choice Award for Favorite Dramatic Movie 2005, won the award for Best Costume Design, won the award for Best Gibson. Mel Gibson won the award for Best Director. This movie, Passion of Christ, received 3 Oscar nominations. It received 3 more nominations at the 77th Academy Awards, one for Best Makeup, Best Cinematography, Best Original Score. It became the 7th highest grossing film domestically and the highest grossing Christian film of all time. And Mel Gibson, the director, you know, he earned something around the range of $400 to $425 million for this movie. I mean, this movie is amazing.
And he all through his career has continued to be one of, you know, the most, you know, some will say controversial, you know, others will say, you know, just simply phenomenal as an actor and as a director. I remember Mel Gibson from the movie Braveheart. And, you know, all the movies where, also, I can't remember the name now.
Mad Max Fury, I think.
But there's the one he did with, oh Lord have mercy, where they were cops and they were chasing.
Person of
bombs.
Interest? No, it was Jim Caviezel, the actor who acted Person of Interest.
I don't remember anyway. But he continued, you know, until Passion of the Christ. The controversy from Passion of the Christ was, of course, expected, mostly because of the Christian faithful and the...
They said he had anti-Semitic undertones.
You know, and of course, mostly also because of the way that people always revere, you know, Christianity and their religion. Mm-hmm. You know, they don't want you to play with it. They don't want you to, you know, mess up, you know, the narratives, you know, with regards to it. And so, yes, the lightning struck 3 times. Conspiracy theorists said, oh, it was because, you know, God didn't want the movie to finish. You know,
interesting.
And, you know, people were, you know, fighting back and prayers and all of that. Even Nigerians here had their own conspiracy theories about the movie. But it was also a struggle for a lot of people to watch because the way that, you know, the last 40 hours of...
Last 44 hours of
Jesus' life was depicted in the movie, for a lot of people was really, really, really gruesome, really
very
scary.
Graphic, yes.
Very graphic, you know. So it wasn't comfortable for a lot of people to watch. When he was being flogged, there was a time that he was being flogged and it looked so, so bad. They had thorns, you know, on the whip that they were using to flog him then. And so for a movie to be able to depict and to be able to put out that level of, you know, graphic imagery on what Jesus suffered, you know, it definitely deserved all the awards.
Indeed. I mean, you know, just flashing back to the behind the scenes of the movie, not that I was there anyway, what I read online. So, you know, they talked about how to make sure the movie was so graphic, so vivid, you know, Jim Cavalier, the actor, would sit down, wake up at 2 a.m., sit down, do makeup for about 8 hours to depict, you know, wounds on his body and all of that. He eventually developed lung infection, pneumonia, and hypothermia because of the conditions, the very cold conditions to shoot that movie. So that's what happened today in history. 25th of February, 2004, Passion of the Christ movie began to show in theaters in the United States.
And that's what you put in to make a great movie.
Indeed.
If you don't put in that level of work, you would not make, you know, a movie as phenomenal as Passion of Christ. And I went back to 1965, Muhammad Ali versus Sonny Liston. That's all we have for you today in history. Coming up next is our first major conversation. Abdul Rashid Bawa has been screened by the National Assembly, or the Senate rather. And what, you know, are the challenges he has ahead of him? We'll be back after the short break.